What's up, y'all? Welcome back to Fish the Moment. So a few months ago, I made a video about how to interpret side imaging and how to understand where objects are relative to your boat when looking at the side imaging image. In this video, I want to go one step further and explain how you can actually identify bass or fish on your side imaging image. So let's get into it. So the first way to identify fish on side imaging is to look for dots in the shadows of objects. And this is kind of a confusing concept, and it's hard to explain by just looking at this flat image. And so I'm actually going to jump over to my studio and give you a real life example of what I'm talking about. Okay, so to explain this first technique for identifying bass using your side imaging unit, I'm going to use this rock here and then a D'Amici rig to represent a fish and a flashlight to represent the side imaging transducer. And basically the way a side imaging transducer works is just like a flashlight in that when I shine this flashlight on this rock, every place where the light from the flashlight is hitting is going to be where you see color on your side imaging unit. So if your color palette is amber, then every place where this flashlight's light is hitting the rock will look amber on your screen. And then if we take a look behind the rock, you can see this nice big shadow behind it. And everything on your side imaging image that looks black, or you have black space, is like the shadow that's cast by this rock being hit by a flashlight. And so basically what you're getting then is a combination of lit up objects, which is where the color is, and then the shadows behind objects, they're sticking, let's say, a foot to 3 or 4 feet off the bottom. And obviously, the bigger and the taller the object is in the water, the longer the shadow is going to be, and therefore the bigger the black space on your graph. And identifying these black spaces in your graph is the easiest way to identify different types of cover on the bottom, like rocks, sticks, brush piles, sunken boats, whatever it is. And sometimes your side imaging image might not be super clear, and so you might not be able to pick out if it's a rock or a stick or a stump, but usually these shadows are pretty easy to identify, especially if you have your settings in your graph set correctly. And I do have a video talking about exactly how you need to set up the settings in your graph, so check that one out using the link in the description below. But now that we kind of understand this whole concept of the shadow and then what the colored space on your side imaging image is, I want to talk about how you can actually identify fish on your side imaging image using these shadows and the light from the transducer to your advantage. So first up, let's take our bait, which represents our bass, and put it behind the rock. So you can see here, the rock is blocking the light from my flashlight, and that means that there's no light hitting the bait. And so the bait is completely covered by the shadow of the rock. But then as we bring the bait up, almost in line with the top of the rock, it's now being hit by the light from the flashlight. This is the exact same thing as a fish that's sitting parallel to the top of a rock in the water. And so what this means is that anytime that a fish is sitting on the bottom or near the bottom behind a rock, it's not going to be hit by the beam of the transducer, or in this case, the light of the flashlight, but when the fish is in line with the top of a rock, it will be hit by the beam of the transducer, and that means it's going to show up as a colorful dot on our side imaging.
So hopefully you have a basic grasp of this concept, so let's now apply it to an actual side imaging image. And if we take a look at an image here, first thing I want to make sure you understand is that the beam of the side imaging transducer originates from this bright line in the center of the screen. So in my real life example, this is where the flashlight would be. And then the flashlight is going to shine left and right, and everything that the transducer's beam hits is going to show up in color, and then everything that is behind an object is going to be a shadow, which shows up as black space. And so here's the black space, here's the colored area. So now that we've sorted all that out, let's look for some fish in this image. And in this image, the fish are right here. They are these small dots that are showing up on top of the black space, and they're right next to a bright object. And this bright object is actually an offshore ledge. And so the top of this ledge is in 25 feet of water, and then it drops off from 25 feet into 50 feet of water, and you have this big black shadow, which is being cast because the top of the ledge is in 25 feet, the bottom of the creek channel is 50 feet, and so there's this elevation change. And so the light from the transducer can only hit the top of the ledge from this angle. It's not hitting the middle of that creek channel. And so what this means is that you're going to have that shadow being cast, and then everything that shows up in that black space is either going to be floating debris or fish. And so in this case, we have some fish that are suspended on the edge of that ledge just over the creek channel. And so if we flip this image around and kind of take a look at it from a 2D perspective, the fish in this image are going to be here. And the light from the transducer is going to be hitting on top of the ledge here. And then everything in the black space is going to be this creek channel that's in deeper water. And so you really can think about this side imaging image as a 2D image a lot of times if you understand how these shadows and the transducer beam interact. So to make sure everything's clear, let's take a look at another example. Here we have a really big brush pile, and you can see the limbs of the brush pile very clearly because they're very colorful and they're being hit by the beam of the transducer. And then off to the right side of this brush pile, you can see a nice black space, and this is a shadow being cast by that brush pile. And if we take a closer look at the shadow, you can see that there are several dots in that shadow, which are fish. And one thing I want to make sure is very clear is that these dots are only going to be fish when the dot is completely surrounded by black space. If we take a look at some of these different parts of the brush pile, you can see that there might be some limbs or small branches that stick out into that shadow, but they're actually connected to the main brush pile. These are just limbs. The only way they're going to be fish is if it's a dot that's completely surrounded by black space and it's not connected to anything else. And so if we take a 2D perspective on this brush pile, basically what this means is that there are fish that are sitting just on the right side of this brush pile, suspended in line with the top of that brush pile. They may have some fish that are actually sitting deeper in the brush pile and closer to the bottom, and these fish are not gonna show up on the side imaging because they are not gonna be hit by the light of the transducer. They're gonna be covered in the shadow of that brush pile. So those fish down closer to the bottom or deep in the brush pile won't show up on side imaging. It's only those fish that are suspended up at the top of the brush pile where the beam of the transducer can actually hit. Okay, so let's take a look at one more example because I know this can be very confusing. And here we have an offshore rock pile, and it's on the edge of a main lake point. And if we take a look at this rock pile, you can see a lot of jagged edges and some nice rock that's being hit by the beam of the transducer. And then some of these rocks are a little bit bigger and they're actually casting a shadow. And if we look very carefully in the shadow of these rocks, you can see that there's one spot where there's a shadow and there's a single dot that's completely surrounded by black space in the middle of these rocks. That's your fish. And again, there may be a ton of fish in this rock pile here, but this fish is the only one that's suspended over the top of these rocks. And so if we take a look at a 2D image, the fish that is being caught out by the transducer is probably sitting in line or just above some of these rocks. And there may be 10 or 15 more fish there down in the rocks or on the bottom, but we can't see those fish because they're covered up by the rocks or they're blending in with the rocks. And so the only way that I can tell if there was fish on the spot is because there was one or two fish that were caught out in the open. And so one thing you wanna do on rocky spots a lot of times is make sure you graph over them two or three times, both with side imaging and with down imaging to see if the fish are in there, because a lot of times a lot of those fish are gonna be sitting right tight to the bottom and you won't be able to see every single fish in that image. But fortunately, in this case, I was able to see a fish that was caught out in the shadow of that rock. So just to be clear, you will see fish in the shadows of objects when they are suspended parallel to the top of the object, or maybe just a little bit below the top of the object. But then as the fish sit tighter and tighter to the bottom and get closer and closer to the rock, they're not going to show up on your side imaging unit. This means that you may not be able to see every single fish that's on an offshore area just by looking at the shadows of the rocks. A lot of times those fish will be right on the bottom and tight to the bottom and you won't be able to see them. But every once in a while, you will see a fish that might be swimming over the top of the rocks and it'll be caught out kind of in the open and you'll be able to see that dot in the shadow of a brush pile or a rock or something like that. And that's when you know that there's fish in that area. So now that I've explained how to identify bass in the shadows of structure and cover, I also want to show you how you can actually identify fish that are sitting on the bottom when they're not around any sort of structure or cover and they're just on a flat bottom, kind of like this table. And in this case, I'm going to be using this rock to represent a bass. And the table here is the bottom of the lake. And so if you pull up our handy-dandy flashlight again and shine it on our rock, which is now our fish, we can see is that this rock is again casting a black shadow because the light is getting blocked by our fish in this case. And again, the light is representing the beam from the transducer. And so when you're looking at a offshore ledge or let's say an offshore hump and there's no cover there, but you still see some black space on your graph, a lot of times those are actually fish. They're just sitting on the bottom and you're seeing the shadows of these fish that are being cast on the bottom. Now, if you take a look at this rock, you can see that the shadow is not very long. And so, unlike when we flip the rock up and we have it taller, you can see that shadow is much longer because this rock is sitting, you know, maybe 2-3 feet off the bottom. But a bass is not going to be that tall, and so the shadow is going to be a lot thinner, a lot smaller. And so I kind of equate the shadows that are cast by a bass to small grains of rice. And if we take a look at some images from my side imaging unit, when I'm seeing bass on my graph, a lot of times the bass on your graph are going to look like small grains of black rice. And basically what's happening is that you're not actually seeing the fish lit up on your graph sometimes. Most of the time what you're actually seeing is just the shadow of that fish that's being cast by the transducer's beam hitting that fish. Now, one thing I'll call out is that this technique for identifying fish in your side imaging is a little bit less consistent than looking for the dots and the shadows of objects. And the reason for that is it's pretty easy to confuse rocks for bass when you're trying to use this technique. And the reason for that is because rocks are going to cast shadows just like bass. And so if you have a bunch of kind of shorter rocks on the bottom, they may cast that, you know, black grain of rice sized shadow on the bottom. But there are some ways you can differentiate between rocks and fish on your side imaging. And the main way to do that is to look for how the shadows are grouped on your side imaging unit. And usually bass and side imaging like to be spaced apart from each other a little bit. As I mentioned in other videos, bass like to have their own personal bubble. They don't like to be stacked right up on top of each other, all grouped in one small area. They like to spread out, have a little bit of wiggle room, elbow room, kind of like humans do. And so a lot of times when you see fish on your side imaging unit, they are going to be somewhat spread apart from each other. And so in this image, you can see that these black grains of rice have maybe an eighth of an inch to a quarter inch, maybe even a full inch between each of the dots, where if you're looking at a grouping of rocks in your side imaging, those rocks are going to be much tighter together. They're going to be stacked right on top of each other, and those shadows are going to be grouped up very tight. And so that's really the main way I differentiate between rocks and fish on my side imaging. And here's one more really good example I have of fish that you can see on the bottom using side imaging. And here we have a roadbed, and there are 3 or 4 fish sitting on top of this roadbed. And if we look really carefully, you can actually see some brighter dots and then a shadow off to the right side of those bright dots, and those are your fish. And sometimes if you have your settings set correctly and you have a newer graph, you can actually see the fish as these brighter dots, but you have to be careful because those brighter dots can also just be rocks. And so you do have to make sure you use context clues to understand if that's a rock, if that's a fish. But here we have that black grain of rice. We have the bright dot. This is another great image of some fish on side imaging. And one more call out, guys, is that it's usually easier to identify fish on the bottom when you're dealing with softer bottom areas. The reason for this is because softer bottom areas have a weaker return, and so the screen is going to show up a lot darker. And then when you get a fish sitting on the bottom of a soft bottom area, that fish will be brighter than the bottom and it will really pop. And again, these can be rocks but a lot of times it will be fish. And so it is pretty easy to identify fish in your side imaging if you're graphing over muddy bottoms or sandy bottoms, things like that. But when you get into an area with a ton of rock, it can be very difficult to differentiate the rocks from the bass. And so you have to use the method of finding the bass in the shadows of the rocks more than trying to find them when they're on the bottom. And one other thing is that it is a lot easier to see fish on your side imaging unit when they're just laying on the bottom if you have a newer unit. I would say that the Humminbird Mega Imaging and Lowrance HDS Live units are great at identifying fish on the graph, but if you have a Humminbird or Lowrance unit that's 2 to 3 or 4 years older, it is a lot harder to actually see these black grains of rice or the little bright dots on the graph. And so what I like to do is use the shadow method if I'm dealing with an older graph, and then if I get the newer graphing technology, the newer imaging technology, I'll start looking for actual fish laying on the bottom. And one other thing that I see guys confused about all the time when they're trying to identify fish in their side imaging is that they're looking for bright dots on their side imaging screen. And a lot of times when you will see a bass on a offshore ledge or a hump on your side imaging, they will show up as a bright dot. And the reason for that is because fish, not a rock, but a fish, has a stronger return than, let's say, a mud or a sand bottom, because a fish has bones, it has blood, it has things like that that will ping the transducer's beam and cause a brighter return than a mud bottom. And so sometimes you can see fish by just looking for bright dots on the side imaging. The problem though is that rocks also have a very strong return because they're made of, well, rock. And so they also show up as bright dots. And so a lot of times when I am teaching guys how to use their electronics, they misidentify rocks for fish because they just see a bunch of bright dots on their screen and they're like, oh, there's a bunch of fish right there. But they're not fish, they're just rocks. And so the more consistent way to identify fish in your side imaging is by using the shadows, looking for those kind of black grains of rice on your screen, and then look how they're clustered on the bottom. That's your best way to go about it. And so hopefully you guys found this video helpful. Hopefully these two techniques for identifying fish in your side imaging will help you find a lot more fish this year. And if you do have any more questions about side imaging, I did make a video a couple months ago about how to interpret a side imaging image, where the objects are in relation to your boat. I actually did it in a big parking lot. So definitely check out that video if you're still a little bit confused on side imaging. And I do also have other videos on bass fishing electronics that I have in a playlist that I'm gonna put a link to in the description below. And so hopefully you guys found this video helpful. It's one that I know I wish I had when I was learning how to read electronics, and it's something that a lot of guys don't teach just because it is something that really takes your offshore fishing game to the next level. And so hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, found it useful, and if you did, please leave a comment down below letting me know what you thought of the video. And other than that, hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see y'all next one.